Yeah, they better apologize, and best of luck to Kissy and her parents. Now, in recent years, media reports on celebrities, usually men, citing sex addiction as the reason they've been unfaithful have made headlines. This is a point where parents send their kids to the next room. Now, which raises the question, is sex addiction real? Well, some experts say so. Jessica is in the studio with more.
Yes, thank you, Antonio. And this issue is a real one. Sex addiction can lead to certain medical conditions, disorders, and emotional stress. Joining us this morning is Dr. Cynthia Gonzalez, our Good Day Valley friend and psychologist with some expert advice for our viewers. Good morning, Doctor.
Hi, once again. Good morning.
A pleasure to have you, and especially this is today's topic is very important. You know, first of all, what is sex addiction and how can you differentiate between just a regular, I guess, sex behavior and sex addiction?
Correct. I think that this isn't a topic that I think it's been highlighted the past few years with some celebrities, you know, claiming to have some addiction to sex and, of course, how it's interfered with their life, unfortunately. But truly, this is something that right now in the field of psychology and psychiatry, we are defining it as we speak. Uh-huh. And what we're talking about here on sex addiction is something that we call hypersexual disorder. Mm-hmm. Hypersexual disorder is when you have an individual that for a period of over 6 months is engaging excessively in sexual behaviors such as frequent masturbation, frequently possibly you know, visiting or using pornography, mm-hmm. Or having multiple sex partners, and things like that over a period of time.
Now, can this be used as an excuse maybe to mm-hmm. cheat on their partners?
Well,
obviously
not. I don't think so, because even if you do have a disorder like this, what's very important, just like with any kind of problem that we have, is treatment and trying to get help for it. I do want to really stress that there are some very normal sexual behavior that people engage in. But what's important to know is that our field at this point, we're doing studies and we're trying to define it more clearly, of course, to help people and helping them so that it doesn't impair their lives. So it's not an excuse for doing bad things and cheating on other individuals, but it is important that if it is causing some kind of impairment, if it is causing some problems, and these are things that do
happen.
What
are some of the problems they can cause, for example?
Well, like for example, you might have, you know, an individual that is engaging in excessive pornography use. Mm-hmm. Well, if they're in another relationship, of course, that affects their own sexual activities. Mm-hmm. And so that mm-hmm. hinders or impairs them. So that's very important. The other part is that this is something that they, in a sense, have. And what we're finding is that they don't have a lot of control over their impulses. And yes. And so it's a very real thing. It isn't someone that is just doing something in a manipulating way.
Now, what would be the first step, doctor, towards, you know, dealing with the problem if the person realizes mm-hmm. actually that it's going under this, through this?
Correct. Well, that's a very good question. So what we want to really know is, what we know right now is that when you have a pattern of excessive hypersexual behavior, such as excessive use of pornography, masturbation, having sex with prostitutes, repeated affairs over a period of at least 6 months, and it's causing distress and impairment in your life, you should seek help, because there is interventions for that, and a person can live a more normal life so that it does not impair them.
All right, Dr. World, thank you so much for your expert advice. Mm-hmm. And if you have any questions, well, we hope you are following us on Facebook this morning and letting us know. If you have any other questions for Dr. Cynthia Gonzalez, just ask away. And speaking of Facebook, Antonio's in the studio with some interesting findings involving the social network. Antonio, thank you, doctor.
Thank you, doctor.